and Johnny have been fishing for about 5 or so years together. We started, I met him in like middle school and decided to take him up north one time to fish, and we just have fished ever since together. Yeah.
I didn't even fly fish at that point. That was like the first experience I got with fly fishing. Zach took me down to the river and caught the first fish I've ever seen caught on a fly, so that really is what got me started in it. And I don't know, we kind of just feed off each other's enthusiasm for it, you know, off each other's stories and tying flies or whatever it is.
Yeah, it's cool to like share the fly fishing experience like with another person. It's cool to like be able to, you know, kind of see how fly fishing works.
Right.
Well, I've been an outdoorsman my whole life. My dad taught me how to fish when I was really young, and I've been fishing my whole life. But then when I got to into high school, he kind of started showing me how to fly fish. Because we have a cabin up in Cadillac on a river, so that's kind of where I learned how to fly fish.
Tying flies is also very technical. You're working with really small hooks and feathers, and a lot of times really thin and fine just material. So it's sometimes it can be really tricky to get it all together and make it look natural. Also, it helps because you can tie specifically a bug that you've seen in one river, you know, that's different from maybe another river, and you can get it matched exactly. Sometimes the fish are picky enough where that makes a big difference.
Fly fishing, like any other sport or, you know, hobby, takes practice and time and patience to get good at. Like, for me, it took, I mean, two solid years to really, like, find that drive and really, really get good at it. But once you find that rhythm and, like, you get that bug, like, you figure out really what you're trying to do out on the river. Like, when you're fly fishing, it's, like, there's nothing like it. You can't, like, you'll never be able to stop.
All right, so with nymph fishing, it's all under the water. We fish them all year in the winter mostly. Dry flies is all in the summer. On top of the water, it's very visual, you know. The fish come up and eat the flies off the top, which is sweet. Nymphing is very technical. On the other hand, it's you got to get the right drift, the right weight, the right depth. Everything has to come together in order to catch the fish. So it's, I'd say, more challenging. But you can probably catch more fish that way. But with dry fly fishing, every fish is awesome because you can see it.
Well, it's really just an escape from reality. Like, I can go, I mean, it's where I fish is like 15 minutes away, and it feels like it's a whole nother like world. Like, some people, you know, snowboard or play sports or something, it's their kind of like way to get out of reality. But yeah, I fly fish.
So last fall, I was out fishing on the Rogue River with Zach Williams and Joe Lane. We were just trout fishing any other normal fall day, and fishing this deep run. I've just made a perfect cast into this deep run, and I'm watching my indicator go down, and then boom, you know. The indicator jumps upstream, I set the hook, and I just felt this weight on my rod. And all of a sudden, the line just starts zipping out of my rod. I knew it wasn't a trout at that point, so I just got the fish on the reel, and I yelled down to Zach because what I had on was a steelhead, and I needed help landing the fish. So Zach came running up, and Joe came running up, and it took all three of us to land the fish. It was about a 15-minute fight, and it was crazy, you know. The fish was huge. It was my first steelhead ever on a fly, and I was just so excited about the fish. And it was awesome also being there with my friends so they could share that experience with me. And I said, "Ricky, Ricky!"
I mean, being in high school, like, I feel like I'm constantly rushing, and everything's rushing around me. I'm always constantly worrying about if I have a test or homework tomorrow or what I have to get done. And fly fishing kind of just shows me a way to just kind of, you know, breathe almost, like, take a minute and forget about my homework and my tests and school and all my worries and just kind of relax and melt into the river, kind of.
Alright, so next year Zach and I are both going to Northern Michigan pretty much to fish and I don't know, explore the wilderness, I guess. There's so much water up there to fish, so it's going to be awesome being able to explore that with Zach since we've been fishing together for so long.
Yeah, it's going to be really cool to go up there and there's tons of water. Yeah, like he said, tons of water to fish, and it's going to be a cool time.
Fly fishing, so you laughed. Just the thought of saying it.
To fly fishing about 3 years ago. Okay, cut.